guys, Ralph here. True Power Trumpet Fitness. Let's get to it. It's a little late in the day, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I usually start my playing long before that, but I had so much to do. My daughter's graduating from high school, and we're going crazy around here. So, let's get to it. Enough said. Okay, as I said, it's a little later in the day, but these are still the first notes. Let's go. The pedals, nice and full. My amount of water key gets stuck every now and then. Does that happen to you? Spit buzz sounds nice and strong. We'll see. Severinsen. May there always be a doctor in the house. That was his, as best as I can remember, that was his Cadenza de Malaguena. I owned that thing when I was in high school. I couldn't finish it up. I'm not sure how it finished. But you get the idea. A little tribute to the good doctor. Now, as you know, if you've been following these things, this guy's in my top five. Mel, I got at the top. Maynard, Maurice, Harry James for his chops. I didn't like the music. I didn't like that, you know. But the chops were sublime, and the good doctor. Now I have to say, I'm going to say this: Doc Severinsen, I think I have more respect for than any other trumpet player. And let me explain. As you know, my top five of all time, I mean, it's splitting hairs. Every single one of them is just awesome. You know, the only thing that I could aspire to. Okay? But the thing about Doc is he was a self-made man. Out of all the chops, those three guys, their chops were very, very natural. Doc did not always have those natural chops. Mel Broyles himself used to tell me, "Ace, whenever I go on a studio date, Doc's there. He moves over. He lets me play lead. You got to remember, Ace, he wasn't always this double C guy that we hear today. He was a self-made man." That's from Mel Broyles himself. And he was. Now, when I played that in high school, if you remember, I heard Maynard Ferguson in college. Okay, so I discovered Doc through records and everything back then, before I ever heard Maynard. And I told you, I was just floored by Maynard, and could anybody do that? And Doc was not doing that back then. He turned himself into by 3 to 5 hours of practice a day. And I'll tell you what, man, he went through 4 wives. He makes no bones about it. You know, the trumpet is not a good instrument for marriage. I didn't get married until I quit the full-time playing. I didn't want to put a woman through that. Anyway, that's not the point. Doc Severinsen. Now, I met him twice. Once was at a concert when I was in college. I was back in Portland, Maine. He was playing the Civic Center in Portland, and my mother got me a ticket. My mother got me a ticket to go see him. Okay, I was home for summer vacation. And again, he was, you know, the leader of the Tonight Show Orchestra, the most visible trumpet player, I think, ever, because of that show. And I went to there, and there was a huge storm in the middle of July. And there was heavy, heavy fog coming in and torrential rain. It was just absolutely miserable. And there was maybe 150 people there in an 800-seat auditorium. I mean, it was not good. And he comes out, and after his first piece, he goes, look, guys, we have to get out of here before the storm really hits. I know you want to get home safe, so we are not going to play with an intermission. We're not going to have an intermission. We're just going straight through. And I thought, oh, man. Here's the big hot dog from Hollywood, and he's going to give us a half an hour and get out of Dodge. I really thought we were getting screwed. 2 hours later, no intermission, he was still wailing, man. He did everything, high and low and fast and slow and pretty and loud and soft. He covered the whole thing. He did a thing, I'll never forget, Turkey in the Straw. I mean, it was amazing. Absolutely amazing, the technique in this little country. It was brilliant. I went up, shook his hand. He was on his way out. Thank you. Blah, blah. Okay. Fast forward. When I was working in New York, I was playing with one of the best brass quintets, freelance brass quintets in New York. We call ourselves the New York City Brass Entourage. And we were playing at background music. It wasn't a concert. We were playing background music for the opening of a Calvin Klein line. Okay, and it's just background music, cocktail music, you know, Bangle Sangoliter and Rondo and all that sort of thing, and some Gabrielli in the background. Nobody's listening, right? And Doc was a major investor in Calvin Klein, so he's at the shindig. And I didn't know it. I didn't know he was there. But we're playing in the Horseshoe, and I'm just sort of, remember, this is just a gig. And I'm sort of drooling on myself, zoning out. We're playing God only knows what. And over the left shoulder of my second trumpet player, I saw this short little guy with a mustache, big grin on his face, shaking his head up and down. And I just sort of came out of my reverie, wherever I was. And I looked, oh my God, it's Doc Severinsen. Give a fist, cut it, guys. Take a 15-minute break. I don't know, Doc, I swear to God, the first thing he said to me, I swear to God, it's not cliche, what mouthpiece are you using? And all he wanted to talk was trumpet stuff. You know, is that a C trumpet? Oh, is that the Schilke? I mean, all he wanted to talk was trumpet. It was the most fun I've ever had talking trumpet with somebody. He was a knowledgeable man, loved the quintet. I said, why don't you come in and sit with us? I said, no. And he says, I have to say, I don't want to feel like a starstruck kid, but you've been my idol forever. And this is what he said to me, and I'm paraphrasing, of course. He says, you should have seen your idol this afternoon. He says, you know, I like to practice every day. And I took a playing date, a solo studio gig for a soundtrack when I came out here to do this. And I came out on Friday. This was a Saturday. Okay? He said, I went all day red-eye. Okay? I hadn't touched the trumpet. I noodled around a little bit in the hotel room, and the sound felt pretty good. Okay? He says, I think I dodged a bullet. He says, I go on the thing today, and everybody, the top guys in New York are there. You know, Bernie Klow and Faddis and all of them. And I'm the big star that's playing a solo from Hollywood, and I had nothing. He said, it was so humiliating. You couldn't believe it. And he says, I'm so sick and tired of revolving my life around this little piece of skin, right? And he's going on and on and telling me about his bad chops. I'm like, you know from bad chops, but that's the way he is. And I have to say, the work ethic that he gave and gave to all his trumpeters, I mean, he was the most visible trumpet player around for a long time. And it could have been some schmo, but he was a professional. And Doc, if you're listening, if this video ever somehow gets back to you, I have to say, I can't begin to say how many times I said to my students, if Doc Severinsen can practice 3 to 5 hours a day, who the heck are you? I said, I can't begin. And you set such a good example. And just your playing has just mesmerized us for generations. He's in his 90s, still practicing 3 hours a day. God bless him. And Doc, I hope everything's well, because you're the best. Okay, give me your comments down below. I'm sure y'all love him as well.